Started the company about 4 years ago, and BetterDoctor is all about helping people find good care. And we do it in multiple different ways. So we started as a doctor finder. We had a website, BetterDoctor.com, and mobile apps that help you find a good doctor nearby, who is accepting your insurance plan, who is likely available nearby. And we also have online booking on our site and so forth. That was the beginning. And now in the last 2 years, we've been moving also into enterprise side. We have a public API that people can embed and implement Doctor Finder on their own apps. We have about 500 API partners today who are using it already. We're also working with doctors and helping the doctors to build a better online presence. So many of the doctors today, they don't have a website, they don't really know what to do online. So we try to help them to build a better presence online so the patients can find and understand who they are. We like to say that we are making doctors heroes online.
Got it. And why did you start BetterDoctor?
I'm a very typical health entrepreneur, so I came from somewhere totally different. I was in gaming for many years and in the tech side. And my wife had health issues in Finland about 15 years ago, and those persisted for years to go. And when I moved to the US about 8 years ago in California, they escalated, and it's really, really hard to find the right doctor. And we couldn't really get the help. We were trying to work with the HR, we worked with, you know, the hospital, the doctors, and nobody really was able to help us to find the right care. So in the end, I was so frustrated that I wanted to do something about it and started this company.
So where do you see the direction of BetterDoctor going? Like, what is BetterDoctor's mission and goal?
I think today, the mission is really the same as from the very beginning. So we want to help people find good care and get healthy. And it's a very complicated market. So we try to pick our battles that really are making our impact the biggest possible. So in the last 3 years, 4 years, we have had about 20 million people on our website who found a doctor. So we have an impact already. And now with the team, we are looking every day, how can we make the impact to be more? How can we get to 100 million people? How can we impact every American every year when they're selecting care? And that can be only done by expanding us beyond the BetterDoctor brand, by working with other consumer brands, working with other apps and services. We work with companies like Yelp and others to try to help them to get BetterDoctor data and help more people who already are using those services.
So if a doctor decides they want to work with you, what are the services that you provide now for them?
Yeah, for the doctors, we, from the very beginning, a lot of doctors are asking us like, hey, you know how to build websites, you are helping people find doctors, can you help me specifically? Because doctors, like you said, they're not tech savvy, they have so many worries, they are focused on so many things that they don't really have the time to learn about online marketing, about websites. And frankly, that's good. They need to focus on being good doctors, helping people. So what we do, we try to build an online presence for doctors that is actually communicating for the patient what they do, why are they good doctors, and why do you see them specifically. So we built them a website, which is home. They need to have a home online. We also we clean all the information on the web so it is accurate. There are too many doctors with wrong phone numbers. There are a lot of directories that your address is wrong, the phone number is wrong, your photo could be wrong. So we clean all that up in a way that people will always find you and your address and your phone number and be able to connect you. And they also find always your photo, they always find the right bio, and they understand what you do. Normally you only know that the doctor is, let's say, an orthopedist. That doesn't take you far. You don't know if they focus on the knees or elbows or so forth. So we tell that information on every possible website out there. We also help the doctors to understand about their own reputation. I mean, today, if you are a doctor and you go to sleep at night, yep, you're going to be worried about malpractice.
Right.
Are you going to get new patients tomorrow? Is everything going to go well? You're also going to be worried about, is somebody rating me badly? Is there a bad review online? So what we do, we collect all those reviews, we give them back to doctors, we report about them. We let them know if something happens. And we also let them get better understanding on what patients are saying about them. So we are sending patient surveys that are giving information to the doctor on what they could do better. So these are really all the different things we are now helping, and I think we are looking to add more. We also are working on the online booking side, working together with companies like DrChrono to be able to embed the online booking on the website.
Mm.
Because as a patient, of course, I want to go to the website for the doctor and book online over there. I don't want to go to another service
right.
to do it.
Okay, so it sounds like you're sort of build. I like what you said, their online home. You're building an online home for them. And part of that includes putting their schedule online. Part of that includes putting beautiful photos of their practice online. So how do the reviews, I know that there's a lot of reviews going on all of these different social networks now for doctors. How does that affect the doctor and what does that mean for the doctor?
That's a really good question. And I think, you know, I look at this in a way that you have about 83% of people today, based on Pew Research study recently, say
mm-hmm.
that they go online to look for doctor information. When you're looking for a new doctor as a patient, 83% of people go to online and normally to Google
wow.
to start a service.
Mm-hmm.
So that's a really big change in the last 4 years. And I love these things when you have a tipping point moment. So today, about half the Americans are going to go look at consumer reviews when they are selecting a doctor. And half of them almost say that that's the most important criteria when picking a new doctor. So when you have 50% on anything, it's a tipping point, and it will soon be 100%. Think about as a patient, if you are looking for a new, or let's say as a consumer, a new restaurant, or you go to Amazon, you're not gonna buy the book that has no reviews.
Right.
You're not gonna go to a restaurant with no reviews.
Right.
It's a defining factor. That is happening now also in healthcare. And I think for a lot of the doctors out there, it's a bit of an eye-opening moment, because today we are in a situation where if a doctor has no reputation at all, it definitely will impact their bottom line. It will impact on how many people will see them. And it will also first time now impact on who are the doctors who are referring patients to you. Am I confident as a doctor to refer my patient to somebody that I know is good, but had absolutely no honor reputation?
Right.
So I might look back because I do it, and am I doing a good service for my patients? So it is becoming an essential thing. And another point I love to say to people is that when you are hiring an employee, you are hiring a salesperson. You want them to have a network. If they have no LinkedIn network, would you hire them? If you are hiring a designer and they have no portfolio,
mm-hmm.
would you hire them? I think very soon, I think hospitals are going to look at doctors and say, if you have no reputation online, we'll hire you. And that will change the game completely. That's why I said tipping points are very important. When tipping point happens, things change fast.
Right. So if I'm a happy customer of a doctor, if I see my doctor, I'm actually happy. What is the way that you get the doctor to engage, the patient to engage, to give a good review? Like what do you do there?
So what we do, if the doctors are customers, the patients are gonna get an email asking, giving feedback. We use the Net Promoter Score, which
okay.
is the most common way of validating good service. Apple is using it, Amazon is using it, Airbnb is using it as a standard for measuring high-end quality. So we do that, and if the patients are giving feedback, they have also an option to go into public sites and leave a review. So what we want to do is that we give an option and we remind the patient that, hey, you might want to write a review about this doctor. And we don't do it today because we don't think about it.
Mm.
But once you are getting a simple, you know, reminder that you could do it, we are seeing a lot of people doing it. And just last week we are looking at one doctor who actually got almost 20% of the people leaving a review
wow.
public sites. And think about that. Now, average doctors are getting 1 to 2 to 3 reviews a year,
mm-hmm.
and those are often the disgruntled patients who might not have even seen the doctor. There might be a scheduling issue, that they never saw the doctor, but they were unhappy about that. They might have an issue with billing. It has nothing to do with the doctor clinical quality.
Right.
So now when we are having more people leaving reviews, you're actually getting a more holistic view. Many people don't know, but an average doctor in the U.S. is seeing about 2,000 patients a year.
Mm.
And today, they are maybe getting 5 reviews out of them. Think about
wow.
a small fragment of a percentage is giving feedback. And that's often very unfair. That's why it's today polarized. You have really good reviews and you have really bad reviews.
Yeah.
Once we are helping more people leave feedback, you're actually going to see a lot more holistic graph of reviews, where you have people who are happy, people who are like, oh, I like this, no problem, or
mm.
people who are unhappy.
So a doctor comes, so say a doctor comes to you guys, and they have no patients. They don't have any patients, they don't have an existing practice. but they decided they wanted to go into their own practice and they ask you guys for help, how do you increase that patient flow?
So I think, like I said, 83% of people are online. If you are setting a new practice and you have nothing today,
right,
and you have no online presence, you are not listed on any site out there, nobody can find you.
Right.
I mean, you're going to be opening your practice.
That's usually when doctors are being stressed is when they do.
Absolutely. You open your doors and you're sitting in a room like this and nobody comes.
Yeah.
Horrible moment. Any small business, anyone who starts a new business like us, I mean, first day, like, I mean, you need to build. It's not automatic.
Right.
So, of course, you can't only rely on online tools. You have to, you know, go out there to the street. You need to, you know, do marketing locally.
Right.
You need to, you know, be able to build the drum and be able to kind of bring people in. Of course, use your friends, use your colleagues, and so forth. But online specifically, what we do first, we build a website. We build a great looking website that has a good story, tells why did you start this company?
Right.
Why are you a good doctor? Why do you practice medicine? What are you doing specifically well? Those are the things we want to highlight. We also want to update, and we update your profile on all the services out there. So if people go to Yelp, suddenly they find you on Yelp. They have good photos on Yelp. They have good information on Yelp. They find you on Health Grades, Vitals, BetterDoctor, and 60-70 different other services.
Right.
And that's a sort of value because all these services, like Yelp, for example, they have about 100 million users a month. So if you are not on Yelp, none of them can find you. But once you are there, they can find you. So then also we look at, in a way, how can we then start getting more feedback about you? Like we agreed already, we care about the consumer feedback and reviews. If you don't have it, you have none, people will not come to you. But
right.
if you are starting to accumulate them, you become more credible. So those are some of the elements we do, and I think there is a lot more to be done when you start a new practice, but we can give you that online portal and online marketing portal and do it really well.
Got it. So you guys help them own their own presence online.
Absolutely.
You're not doing the offline, so that in their own practice they have to figure out like local marketing, that sort of thing.
Yeah.
You get someone local, but you guys will make them have a presence online.
Yeah, today we are moving, I mean, of course, some people are brand new and we help them from the get-go. We are more working with existing practices that are now completely offline. They have no website, they have done radio, they have done newspapers, and frankly, none of that is working anymore.
Mm.
They are frustrated because they spend $2,000 to $4,000 a month on advertising that doesn't make any difference.
Wow.
And suddenly they invest part of that money to us, and we are seeing a big uptake. I mean, I think as a company, you know, of course, we are, as always, you know, trying to find great people. Companies are only as good as the people in them, and we're trying to hire new people. We're looking at multiple positions at the moment, and we're always excited to have people coming in who are excited about healthcare. We really want to hire people who care about this mission, who care about the fact that, you know, we want to make people healthier. And also, I think, you know, as a company, we try to be very open. We try to be focusing on working together with other companies, and that's why we are excited to work with DrChrono. And I think we see that, you know, us small, we've been talking about this multiple times before, but we always said, as small companies, we have to work together. There are a lot of big bad companies out there who are trying to do things, but as small companies, to change the healthcare, we have to work together. That's the only way to do it. And I think both of our companies are really good examples where we try to do that all the time. We try to be open, we have APIs, we are modern, and I think we are now in the forefront of changing healthcare now always.
Awesome. Well, thank you so much, Ari, for being here.
Thank you.